Hello and welcome back to my channel. This is Sarah, and this is the last and final in the series about what coloring books I have and the mediums that are good in those particular coloring books. So this is the first one I'm going to go over, and I chose this one first because it's a really unique book and it has watercolor paper in it, and I love to watercolor in my books. So this is just an extra treat for me to have a book that has real watercolor paper in it. I've seen some reviews about this particular coloring book that said, yeah, it has watercolor paper in it, but it doesn't do very good with watercolor. And I'm here to disprove that. Here is one of the pictures I did with watercolor. And I'm going to zoom in just a little bit more on this, if I can. In this particular one, you can see there are variations in the color throughout a lot of this. And I used the Derwent Inktense pencils for the darker pinks in here. And then I used a regular, like, wash, a pink wash, to get the variations of color that are not the bright pink in here, and the rest of it is done with regular watercolors. And I thought that turned out really good, considering I've not tried this book before, and the watercolors that I had were new to me, so I was pretty pleased with how this turned out. And there is no wrinkle in the paper at all, just normal wear and tear. Now, what I did to get that, the no wrinkle, is I tore it out of the book, as you can see. And because I did that, it's a lot easier to keep your paper flat. If you leave it in the book, it's going to be very difficult to keep your paper flat. So what I did was go ahead and watercolor on this, and then after it was dry most of the way, I laid a heavy book on top so it didn't wrinkle the paper at all. So I wanted to show you that one. And I did another one in here, but I don't know if I have it in here. Give me just a second and I will go grab that. Sorry about that. This is the second one I did, and this has a variety of different techniques on it. It has regular watercolors, and then I used the Zig clean color brush tipped things, markers, and it turned out really well. I did have a little bit of trouble keeping within the lines. That was the first time I tried using the Zig watercolor markers there. So a couple of these spots went outside the lines, like right here. But for the most part, it turned out really well. Very pleased. And again, the paper is not wrinkled anywhere. And so just by putting something heavy on top, or on this particular one, I taped it around the edges on a flat surface, and that stops it from buckling. So, these are my two that I've done from this book, and I wanted to show you the other mediums that I have that are good for this particular book. So, in here, we have watercolor, the Spectrum Noir Alcohol Markers, Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s, Recollections, Spectrum Noir Aqua Markers, Faber-Castell Polychromos, Spectrum Noir Color Pencils, Crayola, Prismacolor, Premier. This one is Fine Liner. This one is Gel Pens, Pastel, Soft Pastels, and Gelatos. Now, I want to say this, I guess, carefully. Colored pencils do not work very well in this book. And that is because it's watercolor paper. If you're going to get these books, use it to its fullest. Use it for the watercolor. So things it did best in this book, I didn't do a test for the Zig Clean Color Markers because when I did all the tests for all my books, I didn't have those yet. And so I didn't want to go back through and do all of that again. So I can tell you that the Zig Clean Color Markers work really well in these books, as well as, and this is the first book I've been able to say this about, the Spectrum Noir Aqua Markers are fantastic. They did a fantastic job spreading around. They did just a great job all around. So those did very well. The NeoColor 2s, Caran d'Ache NeoColor 2s did great. And regular watercolor did great. Gel pens and fineliners will do fine in this book, as well as gelatos. I would not use colored pencil in these books. And here is why. You can see the grain of the paper in here very, very well for this. If you like this look, go ahead and use it. You know, it might look good for wood and stuff like that. Give it more of a grain, but just for general coloring, I would not recommend these for this book, and I would not recommend the Recollections because I don't know how well you can see this, but it left a nice little ring where I laid it down when I tried to spread it around. So these didn't spread very well at all. So that is this one. I also wanted to say before I get too far into these different books that I have that this is going to be the longest of this series that there is because there are so many books. And these are like, I guess, the top of the line kind of books, the ones you've paid a bit more for, and you pay more because you're getting a better quality. So that's what these books are. And I've got quite a few, so bear with me as I go through each one of these. The next one is The Wandering City. And each one of these books have their own review. And you can click on my name down below and you'll bring up all of my videos and you'll be able to see these individually. And I'm zooming in as close as I can for these so you guys can really see how they do on here. So we've got alcohol markers, soft pastels, gelatos, gel pens. This is the, let's see, watercolor, Recollections, Caran d'Ache NeoColor 2s, Spectrum Noir Aqua Markers. Then we have fine liner, Spectrum Noir colored pencils, Faber-Castell Polychromos, Crayola, Prismacolor Premieres, and I believe that's all on here. Things I would recommend. Let me zoom out just a tad. Things I would recommend. I would absolutely recommend watercolor, the gelatos, gel pens, and fine liners. Even the soft pastels did really well in this book. As far as colored pencils go, I would recommend either the Polychromos or the Prismacolor Premier. Those went down a bit smoother. They were much better. Things I would absolutely not recommend would be the alcohol markers because it is double-sided pages and you will lose a picture on the back. And as you can see, it bled through a lot. I would not recommend the Spectrum Noir Aqua Markers. The Caran d'Ache NeoColor 2s in this book did not spread. It left a really nice dark mark where I laid it down and did not spread. The Recollections did the same thing. It left a nice little line here and did not spread out really well. If you're going to use any kind of water-based medium in these books, in this particular one, I would recommend gelatos or the watercolor itself. Regular watercolor paints. So that is this one. And that is The Wandering City. Next, I have a really fun book. And it is called Camper Van Coloring Freedom Collection by Kluteman. And in here, I have done one picture, and this is all done with gel pens. They are metallic gel pens, which is why they shine and shimmer. And these particular gel pens are the Jelly Roll brand. I don't have any other gel pens, so they are the Jelly Roll brand. And they did really well in this book. They did great. They laid down really smooth and, you know, didn't really cover up too much of the black line outlining things. So it worked out pretty good for me. This is my test page. These have some really fun pictures in this particular book. This is probably one of my favorites. It's up there in my top 10. So let me go over this real quick. We have Spectrum Noir Aqua Markers, Watercolor, Spectrum Noir Colored Pencils, Polychromos, Crayola, Prismacolor, Soft Pastels. Right here we've got Fineliner. I know that's a small area, but that's the Fineliner. The Spectrum Noir Alcohol Markers, and as you can see, it goes through on the other side. Over here we have the Recollections and Gelatos, and the last one we have is the Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s. Things I would recommend for this particular book. Recollections did really well. That's the green one. Gelatos did okay. It left the paper pretty rough, whereas the Recollections was very smooth. Just remember, when you use Recollections, soft pastel, it's going to shine and shimmer. It's got glitter in it, so it's going to be kind of glittery. I don't know how well you can see that on camera, but it does shimmer. As far as colored pencils go, I would recommend, and this book, which I don't recommend too often, is the Spectrum Noir colored pencils or the Polychromos. Also, the Crayola did really well. All three of those did better than the Prismacolor in this book. And I used the same pressure for testing these colors. Each one of them, I apply the same pressure as I'm testing it. And the Prismacolor just didn't have the coverage that the others did. So as you can see here, there is a lot of area that's just not colored in here. Whereas the Crayola, the Polychromos, and the Spectrum Noir, each one of these is very well covered. My favorite out of all of these is the Polychromos. My second would be the Spectrum Noir, and third, Crayola. Other things I would recommend for this particular book, if you don't mind losing the other side of the page, alcohol markers do really well in here, and the watercolor did great. Things I would not recommend in this book, I would not recommend the Spectrum Noir alcohol markers, the Spectrum Noir aqua markers, it just does not spread around. I would not recommend the gelatos. It leaves the paper too rough. The soft pastels didn't do much coverage on here. It was really hard to get it to stick to the page. And the Prismacolor Premier colored pencils. I wouldn't recommend those for this particular book. If it's all you got, use it, burnish it, and it should look pretty good. So, the other one I would not recommend is the Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2. And, everything else did pretty good. Even the Recollections did well in this book. And it's not a watercolor book, but the watercolor did really well. So that is this one. And that is, again, the Camper Van Coloring. Next book is Landmarks of the World, Color Your Way from Barcelona to Beijing. This is a pretty neat book. Paper quality in this book is pretty nice. It's kind of a thinner cardstock kind of paper. As far as testing goes, let me zoom in here. almost. There we go. So I'm going to start with, for this particular one, I'm going to start with the colored pencils. I think that's what most people use in the books. So let me go ahead and start with those. Out of Prismacolor, Polychromos, Spectrum Noir, and Crayola, I would recommend, again, Polychromos. It has a superb laydown. It is soft. It laid down very smooth. It has an even coat of color when you're using it. Second, I would pick Crayola. Crayola did almost exactly the same as Polychromos in this particular book. And that does not happen very often. The paper quality in this particular book has something to do with it. It's a really nice, smooth paper, and the laydown is just phenomenal with those two markers. If you have the Spectrum Noir colored pencils, I would also recommend those, but that would be my third choice. Prismacolor came in last. It just did not lay down smooth. There's clumps of color, different places, and especially if you're not using Gamsol or a paint thinner or something to spread it around, it's just going to leave clumps in different places, and that's too bad. I feel like Prismacolor over the years has kind of lost its quality control, maybe, and that's really sad, because they used to be a really good company, and I still like them for a lot of things, don't get me wrong, but they're just not my top choice anymore. Next, we've got fineliners and gel pens. Those both did great. And then we've got pastel, soft pastels, watercolor, Spectrum Noir Aqua marker, and the Spectrum Noir alcohol marker. And on the back side, you'll see that both the water-based and the alcohol marker went through. So I would not recommend either type of marker for this particular book. The watercolor did great, and the soft pastel did okay. Next group, we've got Gelatos, Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s, and Recollections. All three of these did really good. However, Gelatos did not spread as much as these two. And it did leave a nice little line here where I laid it down. Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2 would be my top choice. And the Recollection Collection from Michaels would be my second. I would not recommend Gelatos for this particular book. And again, this one is Landmarks of the World. Next has to be my favorite traveling, city-based kind of coloring book, and it's Around the World in 80 Colors. This one is in my top five favorite. The paper quality in this book is cardstock. It comes with postcards. It's so different from a lot of the other traveling coloring books based on cities and stuff like that that I have seen. It's just a nice breath of fresh air kind of thing in the coloring book world, if you will. One thing, this did not have a test page in it, so I couldn't test it, the colors, too many different places, so I used the title page here. So I'm going to do this one in groups as well, because they're spread out. So, we have got Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s, the aqua markers from Spectrum Noir, alcohol markers from Spectrum Noir, and the Recollection Collection from Michaels. And the one that went through, the others did not, but the alcohol marker went through. I would not recommend the alcohol because they are double-sided, the pages, and I would not recommend the water-based markers. They don't spread. These are supposed to be watercolor markers, and I've only found one coloring book that they actually spread in, and that particular coloring book you saw earlier, and it has the watercolor paper. Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s did fantastic in this book. Fantastic. They spread the way they needed to. They laid down the way they needed to. It was just all around great. Also, the Recollections did really well. Next, we've got soft pastels, gel pens, Prismacolor, Crayola, Spectrum Noir colored pencils, and the Faber-Castell colored pencils, and fine liners. Out of all those, the gel pens did great, fine liners did great, soft pastels did great. As far as these colored pencils go, my top favorite in these would have to be the Spectrum Noir colored pencil. I don't say that too much. There's only a couple other books that I have that the Spectrum Noir would be my favorite lay down in this, but it definitely was my favorite. Coming in second, I would say Crayola, and then Polychromos, and then Prismacolor. So it's kind of a different kind of order than I would normally recommend colored pencils in, which is why it's so important to test your mediums in your book before you start coloring, to see which one of them's going to work better in that particular book. Paper quality is so important. Next little group down here, we have both watercolor and gelatos down here. I would recommend gelatos. I would not recommend watercolor for this book. It didn't do well. So that one is Around the World in 80 Colors. Again, one of my top five favorite coloring books. Next, we've got Romantic Country, the first book. And I put the slipcover, dust cover back on, just to show you the cover of what it was. I don't normally leave them on. They just get in my way. So this is still Romantic Country. First, I'd like to show you this page, which is one that is almost done. And I know if you've seen my reviews before, you would know that a lot of my pages are not complete. This one is no different. I get bored with them very easy, and so I tend to skip around in my coloring books, and I'll come back to it. This was all done with Prismacolor, and it does very well in this particular book. Next page I have is this one. And this one has several different mediums in it. The Trees and the Sky was done with Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s. The House was done with the Prismacolor watercolor pencil. The Grass and This and Her Outfit was all done with watercolor. The Flowers were all done with various assorted different colored pencils. So this has a lot of different mediums in it. So in the back here is what you will see is my test page. So I'm going to do the first column first and let you know which I would and which I would not recommend. Alcohol markers, I would not recommend. Pastels, soft pastels, I would not recommend. Spectrum Noir Aquacolor colored pencil, or I'm sorry, aqua marker, I would not recommend. Watercolor, I would recommend. Gel pens, recommend. Gelatos, would not recommend. For this one, Recollections, would not recommend. It leaves too much of a mark on the page where you laid it down. For the next four, these are in order here of Polychromos, Prismacolor, Crayola, Spectrum Noir, all colored pencils. I would recommend any of these. They all did fantastic in this book. Great, great laydown. Very smooth, very nice. My top favorite, however, would be Prismacolor and the Polychromos. Great sets. Next, there is the Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2. Worked fantastic. Fine liners, as always, really good. So that is the Romantic Country, the first one. Next, there is Wildlife of New York. And this is a pretty neat book, too. The page that I had done most of the way is this one. And I know that these colors do not work well together. I was testing a new set of watercolors that I had. I don't really like them after testing them. And so that's why it looks the way it does. This is not something that I would normally pick out to do the colors in. So this one is done with all watercolor. And as you can see, the pages work really well with watercolor. It takes it very, very well. And the only thing I did to keep this flat is close the book once it was dry, and I put a heavy book on top of that. So let's go back to the test page. Let me zoom in here. And I will go through these one block at a time. So we've got the Spectrum Noir alcohol marker, Spectrum Noir watercolor marker, fine liner, and soft pastel right here. I would recommend the pastel and the fine liner. The other two I would not recommend. They did not go through very much on the back. Right there's the alcohol. The watercolor didn't go through at all, the watercolor marker. But it does not spread very well in this book, so I would not recommend that. Gel pens do great. These other four are colored pencil. So, Faber-Castell Polychromos, Spectrum Noir, Prismacolor, and Crayola. Out of all of these, I would recommend the Polychromos and the Crayola. Both, as you can see, have a much better laydown than the Prismacolor does. So those two are fantastic. For the last little block, I'm starting at the upper left. In the green, we've got Recollections. Next to that, we have the Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s. At the bottom left, Gelatos, and the bottom right is Watercolor. The only ones I would recommend out of this would be the Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s and Watercolor. Straight Watercolor. Gelatos left the page so rough and it started to tear up my page, and the Recollections didn't smooth out very well. It did not spread too well at all. And this one's the Wildlife of New York. Let me zoom out so you can actually see it. There you go. Next, this book is my top absolute favorite for mandalas. It looks kind of like one of those off-brand books that you can get places that's just not going to be very good. Paper quality sucks. However, when I opened this up, I fell in love. So I would recommend, if you don't see any of my other reviews, look for this review on this particular book. It's great. The first page here. This one, you'll have to excuse me as I look to see, as I don't remember exactly. This one was done with colored pencils and fine liners. All did fantastic. The next one was done with colored pencils and gel pens, and you'll see the gel pens is this faded area right here that's kind of a ombre effect. I used water with my gel pens and spread them out, and that's how I got it to look like that. And then the last one was done with felt tip markers and colored pencils and gel pens, and they did fantastic. I don't have a test page in this because there is no room on the title page, and it goes right into the book. and there is no page in the back for me to do that. So I did not want to run any of these pictures because I like it so much. So I'm just going to tell you what's going to work well in this book and what's not. What's going to work very good in this particular book is gel pens, fine liners. Any colored pencil is going to work really well. I have not tried water-based anything except using water to spread out my gel pens. And that did great. It didn't leave the paper rough or anything. So I'm going to go out on a limb and say, yes, watercolor will work in this book. As far as which watercolor-based medium, I couldn't tell you because I've not tried them. However, I really recommend this book. Things I would not use in here are the water-based markers. I really feel like they're going to go through the page and maybe spread into the other areas with those tight spaces that mandalas have. Also, I would not recommend alcohol-based markers like Sharpies and things like that. However, I did use felt tip pens in this, and they worked fantastic. And because the pages are one-sided, just one-sided here, you can tear them out if you'd like, or keep that blotter page behind, and you can use the alcohol markers like that. So that's what I would recommend and not recommend for this particular book. The next books that I have are The Magical City and The Magical Journey by Lizzie Mary Cullen. And I'm only going to do one book here because the paper quality is the same. And I use this as my test page. This has so many different mediums on it, it's not even funny. I used Prismacolor watercolor colored pencils on the sky, the grass, and this particular flower. I used regular watercolor on the paths here, the brick little road here, the sand, and the darker soil. All these roads were done with watercolor. These little circle things here were all done with Prismacolor. I wanted to show you the difference here. I'm going to zoom in on this because it's very interesting. You can see the difference in blending here. This one is Prismacolor. This one's Crayola. You can see the difference. I tried to pick out the colors that were the closest match to each other when I did these, and you can see just blending, the Prismacolor is far better than the Crayola. So I wanted to show that to you, definitely. The ocean right here, all these waves and stuff like that, those were done with Polychromos colored pencils. The sun was done with the Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2.